everyone, I'm Dr. Z. I'm a clinical psychologist specializing in transgender care. Welcome to my channel. So let's talk what to do when your partner, either it is somebody you're in a long-term relationship with or somebody you're married to, doesn't really accept your identity. So let's say, for example, you came out to your partner and you really want to transition, but your partner is very much against it and just refuses to accept it, or maybe they do accept it, but they're pretty much telling you that no, if you are going to transition, that is it, that is the ultimatum, I'm going to walk away. So what to do in those situations? For starters, let me just say this, that this is kind of tends to fall into two categories, because sometimes, and I do see this often in older couples who've been together for a number of years, sometimes what might happen with older couples is that a partner will come out, and a lot of times just by the fact of coming out and no longer carrying this big secret within themselves, it really helps alleviate a lot of dysphoria for that individual. And a lot of times what I see is that a partner might say to me that, you know what, this just has taken a big load off my shoulders. Even though I may have wished to transition, I don't necessarily feel like, perhaps maybe it's in the cards for me because I'm older, or, you know, dysphoria has really decreased just by sharing who I truly am with my partner. And as a result, it doesn't really affect me as much. And a lot of times people can make that decision, a decision to stay together as a couple, to be open that they are transgender, but not really undergo transition. And I think that is okay, and I think that is a personal choice. Now, there is a second category that I want to address today, and that is a category of individuals where you as a partner really want to transition. You really want to undergo any or all aspects of transition because you just feel that it's going to really get you much more congruent and closer to how you identify and how you see yourself in relationship to your gender. And as that type of individual, when you come out to your partner, what to do when your partner is very, very against it? When your partner basically tells you this, I love you, I want to continue living with you, I want to continue spending the rest of my life with you, but you're absolutely cannot transition. That's going to be a deal breaker. So what to do in those situations? Because that is a different situation than situation number one that I described. Now, I'm going to share with you my personal opinion. I think that if you were able to come out to your partner, first of all, congratulations. I think that a lot of times takes a lot of courage in a lot of people. I think that's great. I think that when you come out to your partner and when your partner puts down such a strong ultimatum, personally, I can't fathom a way a relationship can survive or continue to exist as a unit within the scope of that ultimatum. And let me elaborate a little bit more what I mean. Now, when you come out to your partners is going to feel a whole bunch of different feelings. They might at first feel betrayed, angry, rejected, upset, resentful, really sad, heartbroken. They might have all of this and more, different combination of feelings, right? And that is okay, right? Because you are sharing something with them that is one way or another might be very surprising to them, might not be surprising to them, but chances are it will be, and may feel at the moment devastating to them. Notice how I say feel at the moment, very devastating to them. That's just a feeling. So they may feel all of these feelings, and that's okay to feel them. It's not okay, in my view, when a partner tells a person what to do about their medical condition. When a partner tells a person that you cannot do this, you have to stay in a marriage within the scope of your biological assigned sex, and you cannot move beyond those parameters. To me, that is, it's very rigid form of thinking, and I would even venture to say that to me that's borderline abuse. It's psychological abuse because in a way what you're doing, you're leveraging years of relationship. And you're leveraging the fact that that person is so afraid of being alone. And you're leveraging that you know that chances are, if you may not give them a green light, they may continue to suffer. And I think when you're leveraging those things, whether you're aware or not that you're leveraging them, to me, that's a form of being abusive. And sometimes people don't realize they're being abusive, but I don't know what else to call this, right? Because here you have a partner who is sharing with you who they are at the core. And to tell somebody that in order to be with me and continue to live with me, you have to be the fake person you were. You cannot be who you are at the core. So in so many ways, they're communicating to you that I will only love this facade or this, you know, this part of you that is struggling, that part of you that is miserable, this part of you that is in pain. I will only love that part of you. I will not love the true part of you. I'm incapable of loving the true part of you. And what else they're saying is that, please continue to go ahead and suffer at my expense because your transition is going to make me so uncomfortable. And I think it's incredibly unfair and very brutal thing to do. And I don't see how a relationship can continue to survive. A lot of you write to me, a lot of you who are older and been married for a long time write to me, and you express something that really breaks my heart. And what you express is this: I came out to my wife or my husband or, you know, my partner, you know, a few years ago, and they're completely against it. They don't even want to hear about it. They don't even want to acknowledge it. And I don't really want to lose them, so I'm just going to put up with it. And that breaks my heart because that is not fair to you. It's also not fair to them because, and I can't even again fathom how they would want to live within that ultimatum, knowing that that is really not truly you who is showing up for the relationship every single day. And that's painful. And so within that scope, I don't see how a relationship is supposed to survive. It's like, here's a big elephant in the room, but we're all going to walk around the elephant in the room and pretend like the elephant is not there. Not only is that avoidance and denial, it's also ignorance of a very serious medical issue that is hurting and psychologically killing your partner. So when people say, what do I do? In my view, in my opinion, is you have to choose. We all have a choice, right? Just like your partner is giving you a choice by saying, I'm choosing as a partner to stay with you, to stay with a part of you that I know is not really you, but I'm making a choice to continue living in this denial. You're also making a choice by deciding that all of these years of relationship, I'd rather stay in it than allow myself to be me. I understand that the other side of that, the side where you may have to choose to walk away, but I want you to also pay attention to what you're going to walk away toward. You're going to walk away toward yourself. You're going to walk away toward liberation of who you are. You're going to walk away toward healing yourself. I know that it's, for many, ends up being a lonely journey, but let me ask you this. Being in a relationship with a partner that gives you such an ultimatum, is that not ultimately a lonely journey too? Aren't you also lonely and sad and hurt that here's somebody you loved and been close to for a number of years and you share something with them that is tearing you apart and they can't love that part of you and they can't help you do something about that part of you that is tearing you apart? And I think that's incredibly lonely. So in my book, if you came out to your partner and your partner gives you that ultimatum, I personally just don't see a relationship surviving. If it is surviving, I think it's surviving on juxtaposition of falsehood. And I don't think that's a very emotionally rich, happy relationship in my view. Now, again, this is all just my view. You have to decide what to do. But there is no other way. When you come out to your partner and they completely refuse for you to undergo transition, especially if transition is something you so badly want, well then it's pretty much you're saying, I don't want you, I don't want to be with you. And that's something for you to consider. I don't see any other, again, I'm sorry, I just don't see any other avenue or to make things work when the person needs a medical treatment in my book, whatever that may be. And for some people, sometimes it's just a matter of just starting hormones. Some people, because of the age where they're at, and also because of the financial situation they're in, or because of their medical history, sometimes people don't even undergo surgical transition. And for them, it's just starting the hormones to really alleviate the dysphoria, and being out to the partner is enough. But if you're getting ultimatum, I'm really sorry. I really am. And I'm really heartbroken that you're with somebody that is giving you that ultimatum. That is really, really sad because you haven't done anything wrong. You're not a criminal. You're not, you know, some kind of horrible deviant offender, you're a good person who's struggling with gender dysphoria, which is a medical condition, and you really shouldn't be seeking permission from people in order to be who you are. So hopefully this helps. Comment below. I know that a lot of you are in the situation. I know that a lot of you have been in the situation and got out of the situation, especially those of you who came out to your partners and your partners giving you ultimatum. Please share below. What did you decide to do? How did you feel? And I bet you felt very devastated, because how can you not? Share below, how did you found a way forward? What gave you strength to move forward with your life, and especially move forward with your transition? I'd love to hear your comments. I'd love to see what you have to say, and I'll see you guys all next time. Bye.